Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So if you're new here, my name is Ruth and my brand is Stownique. Stownique is all about fashion, events, and now sweets and desserts. So this video is all about where I've been, because it's been a while, what's new, and kind of what's next, what's the next focus for my channel. So let's get right into it. I've been gone for a little while, and within my absence, I really was trying to find a focus on what my channel should be about, because I'm a creative person, and if you're creative, you can relate to what I'm about to say. I can learn visually, so I can do like a little bit of everything. Originally, just a little background, originally my brand Stownique was about weddings and events. That's what I've done since I was young. I attended my first wedding at 5 years old, and I just fell in love. I just knew I wanted to be involved in wedding planning. I would want to go to a wedding every day if I could. So I started helping people out with their weddings and events, and that's how I started out. Word just got out. It was like word of mouth. By the time I was about 14, I would say, I executed my first wedding, like I planned it, and it took place. That was really exciting for me. So through word of mouth, that kind of took off. And then I kind of expanded to makeup. I had one of my brides ask me to do her makeup because she didn't want to hire somebody, because she said that they put too many things on your face and that whole shebang. So she wanted something simple, not even knowing what she really wanted. But I hadn't really done makeup on anybody before. It was just like on myself and maybe my friends as play. So I wasn't like a professional or anything. I didn't get like training, but I did do research when she asked me, and then I went out, got a whole bunch of MAC products. I think that's all I knew was MAC. Got a whole bunch of MAC products, started doing that, and then I just started doing makeup for other people. So with my channel, I didn't really know what to focus on, but I knew that I wanted to have the channel and do this. But I just thought there's so many beauty gurus. Everybody's doing makeup. Everyone is like reviewing products. So I wasn't truly at peace with just choosing that. And then also with showcasing my events, I did put them on my channel. But events is something that's a little difficult to show content on constantly. And that's something I wanted to do for my channel, is have a constant flow of material so people can view it and not just like upload every month or 6 months. And events and weddings are seasonal, so it's not like every week you're gonna have something to post. So as I was researching kind of what to do, I also took it in prayer. I'm a Christian. I believe in prayer. I also believe in prophecy. I believe in God. You know, I believe that if I pray and I ask God for direction and anything else, he will help me through it. So that's kind of what I was doing, just kind of going on a little journey to find out what I really wanted to do with my brand and then how to extend that to YouTube. So through prayer and like other men and women of God, I was led to something that I've been doing all my life. It's like, why didn't I even think of it? But it was more of showcasing my creative side, my baking side. Like, I put things together. I have some things on my channel prepping for parties and things like that. So baking, like baking desserts, was something that I was really led to doing. And it wasn't simple. It still isn't simple. Like, I went on this journey to like relearn how to bake, because I've been baking since I was little with my mom. I remember going to a book sale, and I bought like a cookbook, and it featured baking. It was just like cake and cupcake and things like that. And I was so excited. I brought it home, asked my mom if we could make it, and she said yeah. And from there, we were baking like every weekend, and that was kind of something special we had, like I had with my mom. Shout out to my mom, hey. And so through this journey, I decided to just kind of showcase my creative side so that I can have good content and people would want to watch. It would be activities like I did with my mom. So I would be doing it with my daughter, and if somebody's watching, they can do it with their friends and doing it with their children or something like that, just like a fun activity. So that's kind of my focus, or that's going to be what I want to focus on through my channel from this point on. That's not to say I won't have other things, but I just wanted to have something that I can make sure that I can consistently follow through with. So that's kind of exciting with me. That's kind of exciting to me. And I invite all of you to come on this journey with me. I'm still learning. I'm not like a professional, super professional with everything, but I've spent a lot of time just learning and researching, a lot of fails, some successes. So everything is not going to be perfect, but this is a journey that I want to take. I'm being led to take it, and I hope you guys will come along with me. So the last thing is what's new in my life, and that is me having a baby. I had a baby girl. Her name is Ariella Azaria. She's going to be 2 years old in a couple of months, and I'm very excited about it. God gave us a gift, and I'm forever grateful. Thank you, Jesus. She's like the light of our lives. She's beautiful. She's, you know, every parent says this about their child, but I'm just happy that I'm at this point in my life, because I honestly had a fear, like a phobia of having children. Like if I would hear somebody talking about having children, I would just cross my legs and kind of just cringe, like, don't talk about that. All I had in my head was like the painful aspect of it. But once I got married, it was still a burden for me, but I took time out. I really prayed about that fear, because, you know, I wanted to have children. It wasn't an option for me not to have children. So I really prayed about it, and I got like this sense of peace about that. And I would just say that I'm glad that I did it, and I didn't let my fear overtake me. So I'm gonna let you meet her, and thank you for watching. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do, and follow me on this journey, and give this video a thumbs up. Feel free to leave comments. So thank you for watching me, and hopefully I'm promising that I'll upload more and I'll be consistent so we can be on this journey together. Here's my baby girl. Ari, you wanna come and say hi? Come say hi. It's okay. Say hi. So this is Ariella Azaria. Ari, look over here and say hi. Say hi, everyone. She's not shy, but she's acting shy because she's never done this. Ari, you want to say something? What do you want to say? Yeah. What do you want to say? You want to say hi? Or you want to say bye? So this is Ari. She was born in April. And we're so grateful that God gave her to us. She was a gift, and that's what her name means. Her name means a gift from God. And we're very happy to have her in our life. She's the best thing that has ever happened to us. Oh, and we're very grateful. So this is my baby girl. Say hey, do a little dance. Do a little dance. Hey, do a little dance. Oh, do a little dance. Look over there and say bye. Say bye bye. Bye bye. Okay, give me a kiss. You giving them a kiss? Give me a kiss too. Blow a kiss. One more time. One more time. Okay, bye.